हेलो एवरीवन, माय नेम इज ऋषभ शुक्ला एंड टुडेज टॉपिक इज ट्रांजिएंट इन ट्रांसमिशन लाइन विच इज द पार्ट ऑफ योर यूनिट 4। ओके, सो ट्रांजिएंट मींस आइदर यू हैव कनेक्टेड अ पल्स सोर्स, ओके, और यू कैन कनेक्ट अ डीसी सोर्स बट विद अ स्विचिंग। ओके, एज लॉन्ग एज यू आर गोइंग टू स्विच ऑन दिस ट्रांसमिशन लाइन, व्हाट हैपेंस, देयर इज अ ट्रांजिएंट। ओके, बिकॉज before t is equal to 0, means t is equal to 0, you are just going to switch on the power supply, DC power supply. So before t is equal to 0, there is no voltage source, and after t is equal to 0, what happens, there is a DC voltage source or pulse source. So there is a sudden change from no voltage to some finite voltage. So it will lead some transient, okay, in the circuitry. So this kind of transient behavior can be analyzed either in time domain or it can be analyzed in frequency domain using Laplace transform. So here we are going to analyze the transient behavior of transmission line in time domain. Okay, so first few points I would like to mention over here. Suppose at t is equal to 0, you have turned on the switch. Okay, so if I am saying t is equal to 0 plus, okay, t is equal to 0 plus, what it means, t is equal to 0 plus signifies just at the switching time instant, okay, just after the switching, okay, what happens, this generator or this pulse source will see an equivalent impedance, which is nothing but the characteristic impedance of your transmission line. Okay, at t is equal to 0, you have just turned on the switch. So at t is equal to 0 plus, that means just after the switching, what happens, this generator will see an equivalent load, which is equal to the characteristic impedance. Okay, so equivalent electrical network you can draw here. Okay, so this generator or pulse generator will see an equivalent load impedance, which is equal to characteristic impedance. So what happens at t is equal to 0 plus, what is the voltage, across this input terminal, this is your input terminal. Okay, so this is the input terminal of your transmission line. So at t is equal to 0 plus, what is the voltage across input terminal, which is nothing but V naught. So V naught is what, you can apply the potential division, Z naught divided by Z naught plus Zg multiplied by Vg. So this is the amount of voltage which will be appear across the input terminal of your transmission line just after the switching. Okay, now in the same way, what is the current? So current can be obtained by simply dividing the total impedance. Okay, so Vg divided by Z naught plus Zg. So Vg divided by Z naught plus Zg is your total current just after the switching. Okay, so in this way you can find out what is the total current and total voltage across the input terminal just after the switching instant. Okay, now here what I have assumed, the transmission line has some finite length equal to L, as well as the transmission line is lossless. Okay, please keep in mind, I have assumed the transmission line as lossless line and it has some finite length which is equal to the L. So what is the phase velocity for a lossless line? The phase velocity here I can represent what I have stated in the earlier lecture. Phase velocity Vp is equal to 1 upon under root Lc. Okay, so what you need to do, you need to find out what is the phase velocity of this transmission line. Okay, so once you have calculated the phase velocity of the voltage and current wave in this transmission line, so I think you can calculate what is the time voltage or current wave will take in order to reach, starting from this point to this point. Okay, that means at t is equal to 0, you have turned on the switch. Okay, so after how much time the voltage and current wave will appear at this terminal. Okay, so that means the voltage and current wave will have to travel a distance which is nothing but equal to the length of transmission line. Okay, with a velocity equal to Vp. So I think you can find out what is the transit time T1. Okay, so this time taken by the voltage wave in order to reach from this terminal to this terminal is called as transit time. Okay, so transit time is equal to nothing but L upon Vp. Here in the textbook it is mentioned as U, but in my lecture I have mentioned it as Vp. Okay, phase velocity Vp. So what is the transit time? So in general, transit time is nothing but transit time is equal to total length of the transmission line L divided by phase velocity Vp. Okay, so in this way you can calculate how much time the voltage and current wave will take in order to reach starting from this point up to this point. Okay, now next thing, What happens under the steady state condition? Under the steady state condition, that means the situation when I can say the transient behavior of the transmission line will get settled down. Okay. Steady state condition is the condition when every disturbances in the system will get settled down. Okay. So that is called as the steady state condition. So under steady state condition, which I can assume numerically as t is equal to infinity. Numerically, I can assume t is equal to infinity as a steady state condition, okay, but t has some finite time duration, okay, so steady state time has some finite value, it is not exactly infinity, but we can roughly say at t is equal to infinity, there is no such kind of disturbances. So under steady state condition, what happens to the overall circuitry, okay, what happens to the overall circuitry, again, we can say, under steady state condition, okay, under steady state condition, this generator voltage source, that means this voltage source will see an equivalent load impedance, which is nothing but the load of transmission line ZL, okay, load of transmission line ZL. So make sure just after the switching, the voltage source, this voltage source will see an equivalent load impedance, which is nothing but equal to the characteristics impedance. While under steady state condition, this generator or this voltage source will observe or it will sense an equivalent load, which is nothing but equal to the load of this transmission line. So I think under steady state condition, you can see what is the total current. The total current is Vg divided by Zg plus ZL. And in the same way, what is the total voltage? I think you can calculate the total voltage as ZL divided by ZL plus Zg multiplied by Vg. So in this way, it's simple network analysis. So I think in this way, you can calculate what is the total current and total voltage just after the switching as well as just in steady state condition. The only two things you have to keep in mind is just after the switching, this generator will observe an equivalent load, which is nothing but equal to the characteristics impedance of this lossless transmission line. And under steady state condition, this generator will observe an equivalent load, which is nothing but equal to the load of this transmission line. Okay. The second thing you need to calculate, you need to find out the speed of voltage and current wave inside this transmission line, or in other way we can say you have to calculate the phase velocity of this transmission line. So the phase velocity Vp is nothing but 1 upon under root LC for the given transmission line. Okay, so I think you can calculate the phase velocity. Now since the transmission line has finite length, okay, so voltage and current wave will take some finite time in order to reach, in order to start from Z is equal to 0 and traveling towards the load side and move up to Z is equal to L. So if the voltage and current wave will start traveling from Z is equal to 0 point and move up to Z is equal to L, so they have to travel down by a finite distance, which is nothing but equal to the L. So if the phase velocity has some finite value, so definitely it will take some finite time. Doesn't matter if the phase velocity is very high, doesn't matter what is the magnitude of this transit time, but actually the value is very, very small, but we have to consider that value. Okay, so this time duration is called as transit time. So now analysis can be done on the basis of bounce diagram. So on the basis of this one, I will have to draw the what we can say bounce diagram or lattice diagram, on the basis of which I can plot the voltage and current wave with respect to the time. Okay, so just quickly recall the things which I have stated. The first thing, at just after the switching, what happens, this generator will see an equivalent load, which is equal to the characteristics impedance. So overall equivalent electrical network will become like this. Okay, and under steady state condition, this voltage generator source will see an equivalent load, which is nothing but the load of this transmission line, and hence the equivalent electrical network will be something like this. So I think you can find out the voltage and current value just after the switching as well as in the steady state condition. Okay, the second thing, you need to calculate the phase velocity. Why phase velocity? Because you need to find out the transit time. Okay, transit time of voltage and current wave. Now the third point, we need to find out reflection coefficient at the input side as well as at the load side. Now the question is why? Because when the wave will travel down towards the load, okay, because of the mismatch in the impedance at the load side, some of the voltage and current wave will get reflected. okay, some of the voltage and current wave will get reflected while rest of the part will be absorbed by this load impedance. So in order to find out the reflected wave, okay, we need to find out what is the reflection coefficient at the load end. Now another question is why we need to calculate the reflection coefficient at the input side. As we have already seen, we can find out equivalent impedance at the input terminal, which is nothing but Zin. So because of the mismatch, because it has some finite value of Z naught, so Zin does not equal to the Z naught. Okay, the input impedance of this transmission line is no longer equal to the characteristics impedance. That is why at the input side there is impedance mismatch. Okay, so what happens when the reflected voltage and current wave will move towards the input side? Because of the mismatch here, because of the mismatch at the input side, what happens? Some of the voltage and current wave will further get reflected, okay, further wave will get reflected, and what happens, this reflected wave will travel down along with this forward wave, okay, along this forward wave, okay. So in this way the voltage and current wave will flow in this travel in this transmission line. So that is why we need to find out what is the reflection coefficient at the input side as well as reflection coefficient at the load side. So you know what is the reflection coefficient at the load side? It is nothing but gamma L. So I think all of you know what is the value of gamma L. Gamma L is nothing but ZL minus Z0 upon ZL plus Z0. So I think you can find out what is the load impedance at the what is the reflection coefficient at the load side, which is nothing but gamma L. So gamma L is nothing but ZL minus Z0 upon ZL plus Z0. In the same way, if you know the input impedance Zin, so I think you can find out the reflection coefficient at the input side, gamma I. Just replace ZL by Zin. Okay, why? Because you can assume like this, this transmission line is terminated by a load at the Z is equal to 0 side. At Z is equal to 0 side, this transmission line is terminated by a load which is equal to the Zin. So I think you can find out the reflection coefficient gamma I is nothing but Zin minus Z0 upon Zin plus Z0. The only thing you need to replace ZL by Zin. Why? Because you can thought of like that, whatever is the reflected wave is moving towards the input side. So reflected wave starts moving from the load side. So for this reflected wave, this terminal is behaving like a source. Okay, this terminal will behave like a source while this terminal will behave like a load. Okay, so this reflected wave will moving from this apparent source towards this apparent load. So what is the apparent load? Apparent load is nothing but the input impedance of this transmission line. So that is why you have to find out the reflection coefficient gamma I at the input side, which is nothing but Zin minus Z0 upon Zin plus Z0. So the third step, you need to calculate what is the reflection coefficient at the load end, okay, as well as what is the reflection coefficient at the input side. Okay, so once you need to once you have calculated all these things, so it is very easy to draw the bounce diagram and hence plot the voltage and current wave. Okay, so I am just moving towards the numerical problem because it will better give the flavor of how to solve the problem. Okay, how to solve the transient how to do the transient analysis of the transmission line. Okay, so just moving towards this numerical problem. Okay, so this is called as your bounce diagram. Now for the transmission line of figure 11.27, so 11.27 is this one, this transmission line is given to you. Okay, calculate and sketch the voltage at the load as well as generator end for 0 to 6 microsecond, the current at the load and generator end for 0 to 6 microsecond. Okay, so you need to find out the voltage and current in this time duration. Okay, so let's see, this is the transmission line which is given in the problem. Z naught is given as 50 ohm. Phase velocity is already given to you, that is 10 to power 8 meter per second. The load impedance ZL, load impedance ZL is given to you, 200 ohm. Okay, the length of the transmission line is given to you, which is nothing but 100 meter. Okay, a DC voltage source of 12 volt is applied with a source resistance 100 ohm. Okay, at t is equal to 0, the switch is turned on. That means at t is equal to 0, switching is done. Okay, so now the question is how to solve this problem. Okay, how to solve this problem? So in order to solve this problem, what you need to do, you need to just find out the reflection coefficient at the generator and the at the load end. Okay, at the generator side, at the load side. So the first thing is you need to find out the impedance at the generator side. Okay, impedance at the generator side. So now what is the Zin? Okay, so I think what is the Zin in order to what I have told you, let us see here. Here in this diagram, for this reflected wave, this terminal will behave like a load, virtual load for this reflected wave. Okay, now the thing is that what is this Zin? Thus, can I say this Zin can be calculated by using the formula Z naught within the bracket ZL plus JZ naught tan beta L upon Z naught plus JZL tan beta L? No. Okay, because we cannot find out Zin by using that formula. This is not the equivalent input impedance of this transmission line. Why? I am just giving the answer. Okay, see, for this reflected wave, okay, here this terminal will behave like a virtual source, okay, while this terminal will behave like a virtual load, okay, virtual load. So in order to analyze the what is going to happen with this reflected wave, what you need to do, you need to deactivate whatever is the source, okay, available at this side, because this terminal will behave like a load, okay, this terminal will behave like a virtual load. So in order to analyze the effect of this virtual load, what you need to do, you need to short circuit this generator. If you will short circuit this generator, what happens at this side, what is the virtual load, this ZG will be directly connected towards this side. So in this way, we can say at this terminal, okay, an equivalent load is nothing but ZG. The equivalent load is nothing but ZG. Or if you are getting confused, just omit this Zin. If you are getting confused with the previous, so just like ZG. Okay, so here you will see an equivalent impedance nothing but equal to ZG. Why? Because in order to analyze the effect of this virtual load, what we need to do, we need to deactivate VG, okay, in order to better analyze the effect. So what is the total impedance? You have turned on the switch, so this terminal is directly connected to here and this terminal is directly connected to here, so that is why the total impedance is nothing but ZG. Okay, so gamma I, or we can say gamma G, okay, because of the generator side. Okay, so moving towards the numerical problem, first of all, I would like to calculate the generator side input impedance reflection coefficient. So it is nothing but in place of ZL, you have to put the virtual load ZG. So ZG minus Z0 upon ZG plus Z0. So it is nothing but it is equal to the 1 by 3. In the same way, for this load, you can find out the reflection coefficient. It is nothing but ZL minus Z0 upon ZL plus Z0. And it will turn out as 3 by 5. The next thing, you have to find out the transit time. How much time the voltage and current wave will take from moving, starting from this point or starting from this point. So it is nothing but total length divided by phase velocity. So 100 divided by phase velocity is given to you. That is 10 to the power 8. That is 1 microsecond. Okay. So 1 microsecond is the transit time. So you have calculated the reflection coefficient and you have calculated the transit time. What is the next thing? You have to find out the initial voltage. Okay. So what I have told you, just after the switching, what happens, this generator will see an equivalent impedance, which is nothing but equal to the characteristics impedance. So what is the initial voltage? It is nothing but Z0, equivalent impedance, load impedance is Z0, Z0 divided by Z0 plus 100. So Z0 divided by Z0 plus ZG, ZG is your 100 ohm. So you can solve and find out the voltage is 4 volt. Okay, so now see, I'm just going to start the bounce diagram, how to draw it. Okay, so here this is my generator end, this is my generator end, and this is my load end. The total time the wave will take moving from this point is what? The total time is 1 microsecond. Okay, please keep in mind. So at t is equal to 0, the voltage has the value equal to 4. Okay, t is equal to 0, what is the starting point? At this point, this point is nothing but Z is equal to 0 point. So voltage wave which has the amplitude of 4 volt will start moving, will start traveling at t is equal to 0. A voltage wave which has the amplitude 4 volt will start traveling at t is equal to 0 from this point Z is equal to 0. Okay, so which is denoted here, a voltage wave which has amplitude 4 volt will start traveling from Z is equal to 0 point at t is equal to 0. Okay, so it 4 volt amplitude wave will move. Okay, once it will reach at this load side. So how much time it will take? It will take a total of 1 microsecond. Okay, why? Because we have calculated what is the transit time. It is 1 microsecond. So after 1 microsecond, this voltage wave will strike at the load end. Okay, so I have told you, because of the load there is some reflection. So what is the reflected amount? Reflected amount is what? If the incident voltage is 4 volt, so what is the reflected voltage? Reflected voltage is what? Incident voltage multiplied by reflection coefficient. So the reflection is done at the load side, so the reflection coefficient should be considered at the load side. So the incident voltage, that is 4 volt multiplied by reflection coefficient, so I think it is 2.4. okay, it is 0.8 and 2.4. so 2.4 volt will be reflected towards the generator side. Okay, so 2.4 volt will take some finite time. Okay, this wave will start moving from this point to this point. So t1 is what? T1 is nothing but 1 microsecond. Okay, so at 1 microsecond, what you will observe? You will observe the total voltage is equal to 4 plus 2.4, that is 6.4 volt at the load side. You will see the total voltage, okay, that is nothing but 6.4. Here, if at any time, if you will see, let us suppose at this time interval, after t is equal to 1, that means in this time duration, let me show you, in this interval, if you will observe the total voltage at the load end, it is nothing but the sum of these two, that is 4 volt plus 2.4, that is 6.4 volt. Okay. Now the 2.4 volt will move towards the input terminal side. Okay, and it will strike at the input side at time equal to 2 microsecond. T1 is 1 microsecond, so it will strike at the time 2 microsecond. 1 microsecond from generator to the load, and again 1 microsecond from load to the generator. So at t is equal to 2t1, it will strike at the input side, and because of the reflection, okay, because of the impedance mismatch at the input side, it will take some finite reflection at the input. Okay, and rest of the voltage will move towards the input source. Okay, so what is the reflected amount? The reflected amount is nothing but the incident voltage. What is the incident voltage? Incident voltage is 2.4. okay, incident voltage is 2.4 multiplied by what is the reflection coefficient at this terminal? Reflection coefficient at the input terminal is 1/3, so it is nothing but 1/3. So I think it's 0.8. so 0.8 volt will be reflected back towards the load side. So the 0.8 volt will be reflected towards the load side. So if I'm asking, in this duration, if we will observe, if we will measure what is the total voltage at the input side, the total voltage is nothing but sum of all these three. So that is, this voltage is 4 plus 2.4 plus 0.8. So it is 7.2. So in between 2T1 to 4T1, in between 2 microsecond, T1 is 1 microsecond. So in between 2T1 to 4T1 time duration, if we will measure the voltage at the generator side, it will become 7.2, which is sum of these two, 4 volt plus 2.4 volt plus 0.8 volt. So equivalent to 7.2 volt. So now 0.8 volt will move from generator and it will strike at the load end after 1 microsecond. So here at 2T1, it will start it flowing from the generator side. After 1 microsecond, it will strike at the generator. So what is the total time it will take? It will take total time 3T1. With respect to t is equal to 0, at t is equal to 3T1, the 0.8 volt will strike at the load end. Okay, so because of the further impedance mismatch, there is some finite reflection. And what is the value? Value is what? Incident voltage, that is 0.8, multiplied by what is the reflection coefficient? The reflection coefficient is 3/5. If you will calculate 3/5, so if you will calculate, you will see the voltage is, reflected voltage is 0.48. so now in between 3T1 to 5T1 time duration, if you will observe or if you will measure the voltage at the load side, okay, in this time duration between 3T1 to 5T1, if you will measure the total voltage, it will be comes out the sum of all these three, that means 4 plus 2.4 plus 0.8 plus 4.8. so it is nothing but, already we have done up to this point, we have done 6.4. so 6.4 plus what I can say, 0.8 plus 0.48. okay, or if you are getting confused, so it doesn't matter. What you will see, you have to draw the just line and see how many lines are intersected. So here, in order to draw a line, if you draw the line, if this red line will intersect intersect this one, this one, this one, and this one. So that is why you have to add all these four. So 4 plus 2.4 plus 0.8 and plus 0.48, it will become 7.68. So 7.68 volt will be appear across the load in between the time duration 3T1 to 5T1, while 0.48 volt will be reflected back towards the generator side, and after 1 microsecond, that is at 4T1, it will strike at the generator side, and further there is a reflection of because of the impedance mismatch at the generator side, there is a reflection, and the reflected voltage is what? Reflected voltage is what? Incident volt 0.48 multiplied by reflection coefficient. And what is the reflection coefficient? Reflection coefficient is 1/3. So I think it's 0.16. So 0.16 volt will start moving from generator towards the load side. So in between 4T1 to 6T1, in between 4T1 to 6T1, if I'm asking what is the total voltage at the generator side, so just it is nothing but sum of all these three. So just draw a line. How many line? Okay, the tip of the line should be in between 4T1 to 6T1. So this red line will intersect this line, this black line, this black line, this black line, and this black line. So the total voltage is what? 4 volt plus 2.4 plus 0.8 plus 0.48 plus 0.16. So it is nothing but 7.84. So in this way, you can draw the bounce diagram for the voltage, and hence in the same way, you can draw the bounce diagram for the current wave. Okay, for the current wave, everything remains same in spite of using 4 volt voltage. You have to consider the initial value of the current, and the rest of the thing, rest of the procedure and everything remains same. Okay, so in this way you can calculate the reflected voltage and current wave. Okay, so now at the infinity, that means under steady state condition, what happens? The generator will observe an equivalent load, which is nothing but the load of your transmission line. So it is nothing but total voltage is what? ZL upon ZL plus ZG. So you will calculate, you will find out the total voltage as 8 volt. Okay, so it is very easy to draw the voltage. Okay, it is very easy to draw the, I think this is the diagram at the generators. Okay, the first figure is at the generator side, so you can draw it easily. Okay, on the basis of your bounce diagram. So what you have to do, you have to just scale this time axis in microsecond. Why microsecond? Because my transit time is also in microsecond. So what is the transit time? Transit time has the unit of 1 microsecond. Okay, so you can see, first of all, I would like to draw the let me erase everything. Okay, then I will move towards how to draw the graph. Okay, it is very easy. Okay, bounce diagram. Once you have I don't think there is any typical thing in the bounce diagram, and once you have successfully draw the bounce diagram, rest of the thing is very simple. You can easily plot the graph. Okay, now see, this is the point at t is equal to 0. Okay, t is equal to 0. Now the next time when the voltage wave will strike at the input at the generator end is what? 2t1. What is t1? t1 is your flight time, is your transit time, which is 1 microsecond. So 2t1 is what? 2 microsecond. Okay, so in between 0 to 2 microsecond, what is the voltage at the generator side? The voltage at the generator side is what? You have to, in between this line, we have to draw a line. Okay, whose tip is in between these two, so it will intersect only this black line. Okay, this is the trick. Okay, you can use your own trick, or you can just, if you have better understanding, you can directly go through the statement. Okay, in between t is equal to 0 to t is equal to 2 microsecond. Why 2 microsecond? Because 1 microsecond time duration will be taken by the voltage in order to move from generator towards the load side, and further 1 microsecond will be taken by the voltage wave in order, the reflected voltage wave, in order to move from the load side towards the generator side. So it will take, ultimately the voltage wave will take a total time duration of 2 microsecond in order to further strike at the load end. Okay, so that is why in between t is equal to 0 to t is equal to 2 microsecond, what is the voltage? The total voltage is what? 4 volt. Okay, so that is why here between 0 to 2 microsecond, what is the total voltage? Total voltage is 4 volt. Okay, now between 2t1 to 4t1, that is the next time step between 2 T1 to 4 T1, because again 1 microsecond here and 1 microsecond here. So total starting from t is equal to 0, 1 microsecond plus 1 microsecond plus 1 microsecond plus 1 microsecond. So here up to 4 microsecond. So in between 2 microsecond to 4 microsecond, in between 2 microsecond to 4 microsecond, what is the total voltage? The total voltage, if you need to calculate, the total voltage is what? Sum of this one plus this one plus this one. So it is 4 plus 2.4 plus 0.8. 4 plus 2.4 plus 0.8, it is 7.2 volt. So in between 2 to 4 volt, in between 2 to 4 microsecond, in this time duration, the total voltage is 7.2. okay, 7.2. Now again, let me draw it. Okay, now again, between 4 T1 to 6 T1, again 1 microsecond here and 1 microsecond here. So starting from t is equal to 0, 1 microsecond plus 1 micros plus 1 up to 6 microsecond. So in between 4 microsecond to 6 microsecond, what is the total voltage? The total voltage is what? 4 plus 2.4 plus 0.8 plus 0.48 plus 0.16. If we will add up all these things, it will get to 7.84. Okay, so the total voltage is, in between 4 to 6 microseconds, the total voltage is 7.84. In the same way, I think you can find out what is the total voltage between 6 microseconds to next is 8 microseconds. Between 6 to 8 microseconds, the total voltage is up to this one, 7.968. So it is 7.968. So dot dot at t is equal to infinity, what is the total voltage? You can find out the total voltage, which is calculated as 8 volt. So at t is equal to infinity, the total voltage will comes out as 8 volt. Okay. Now in the same way, I think you can plot for the load voltage with respect to time. So in order to draw the load voltage diagram with respect to time, okay, now we need to consider the load side. Okay. So I'm just moving towards the load side. Let me erase all these things. Okay, fine. Now here t is equal to 1 microsecond, then after 1 microsecond plus 1 microsecond, that is 2 microsecond. So here the time is 2 microsecond, here the time is 5 microsecond, and here the time is here the time is 1 microsecond, and then again total transit time is 1 microsecond plus 1 microsecond is 2 microsecond plus this time duration 3 microsecond, because at t is equal to 1, it will start moving like this. Okay, so with respect to t, see, all these time durations are denoted with respect to t equal to 0. So here at t equal to 1 microsecond, the reflected wave will start moving like this. So with respect to t is equal to 0, the total time at this point is what? 1 microsecond plus 1 micro plus 1 micro. So it is nothing but 3 microsecond. Okay. So if we can draw between t is equal to 0 to t is equal to 1 microsecond, if I will ask you, in between this time duration, does there any voltage wave? No, there is no such voltage wave at the load side. So the value should be equal to 0. So you can see, in between t is equal to 0 to t is equal to 1 microsecond, there is no such voltage. So that is why the value should be equal to 0 volt. Okay, the value is equal to 0 volt. Now at t is equal to 1, the voltage wave will strike. So just after t is equal to 1, we don't have to analyze at just t equal to 1. Why? Because at t equal to 1, some wave is incident and some wave is reflected back. So we have to see just after t is equal to 1. So what happens to the, there is some kind of superposition and all these things. Okay, so we have to analyze in between 1 to 3. So in between 1 to 3 microsecond, what is the total wave? The total voltage wave is nothing but sum of these two, 4 volt plus 2.4. So in between 1 microsecond to 3 microsecond, the total voltage at the load side is what? The sum of this one and this one. So 4 plus 2.4, which is nothing but equal to 6.4. So the value is equal to 6.4 in between, what I can say, 1 to 3 microsecond. Okay, 1 to 3 microsecond. Now, in between 3 to 5 microsecond, we have to analyze. So in between In between 3 to 5 microsecond, what is the total voltage at the load? The total voltage at the load is what? 4 plus 2.4 plus 0.8 plus 0.48. If you will add up all these things, it will comes to 7.68. So the total voltage between 3 to 5 microsecond is 7.68. So in this way, you can also plot, and under steady state condition, this transmission line will behave like a direct conducting wire. So that is why the whatever is the voltage at the input terminal, it will be appear at the output side. Okay, why? At the steady state condition, what happens? These the two wire transmission lines will behave like a simple conducting wire. You can say they are perfect conducting wire. So that is why the load will be directly appear across the input side. Okay, or we can say whatever is the voltage at the input side, it will directly appear across the load side. Okay, so that is why at the steady state condition, whether it's the generator side or at the load side, the voltage will equal to the same, and it is nothing but 8 volt. Okay, and this load will directly appear across the input terminal. Why? Because this two wire transmission line will behave like a short circuit conductors. Okay, thank you.